Welcome back to Special Relativity A20. In this section, we want to talk about proper velocity. We have seen already concepts of proper time and proper length as the time and the space as seen in the object's own reference frame. So now we want to try to find something similar for velocities. As we have seen, the Lorentz transformation applied to velocities are of a quite difficult form. As a reminder, velocity is given as a change in space over a change in time. We have seen the Lorentz transformation of a velocity x in a reference frame, which is boosted in the same direction x. And you see that, you know, there's this new velocity x prime is given by ux minus v. So there's a velocity addition going on, which is corrected then by this factor 1 minus ux v over c square. You've also seen that even so, the boost is in x direction, there's also a modification of the velocity in y direction and in z direction. Okay, so you see that basically there's the velocity itself is corrected with this new factor. Note here that there's a special case in which the velocity in x direction is equal to zero. Think about this object being in its own rest frame again, where the velocity in the boost direction is zero. You see that those equations simplify for ux prime, that would be simply even to equal to minus v, where uy prime would be uy prime and uz prime would be uz. Okay, so let's try to get at it. Let's try to express velocities in terms of the proper time, as the time as it ticks in the object's reference frame. So we have seen that the time is given by gamma times the time in the rest frame, or time in the proper in the times gamma times the proper time. Note here that we have two different gamma factors to play with. One is the gamma factor of the Lorentz transformation, and this gamma here is the gamma using the speed of the object in a specific reference frame. So this is a gamma, which is a gamma factor, which is a gamma of v of the velocity or the speed of the object. And now we can just simply define proper velocity. I use this vector eta here, which is a four vector, which is the derivative of the spatial component with the proper time. And when we do this, we find this relatively simple solution of gamma times c for the zeroth component, gamma times ux, gamma times uy, and gamma times uz for the last component. So the question now is, you know, we defined this new velocity of an object where the time of the object ticks as it's in its own reference frame using its proper time. Okay. If we now do Lorentz transformation on this, we can, you know, simply apply the matrix for Lorentz transformation on this four vector and find this solution here. You can see that this is consistent by doing this with the original components in this proper time as well. You see that those actually are consistent answers. That makes a lot of sense.